In this video, I will demonstrate how you can identify an underserved niche in any market, generate a business idea from it, and then build a working prototype in just a few minutes using AI chatbots. We will actually use two apps here. One is InfraNodus that identifies market gaps and then uses AI to generate business ideas from them. And the other one is Bolt that can build you a whole website or a landing page just from a prompt. And you can then even deploy it online so it becomes available to your clients and you can use it to estimate if there's any interest for this idea. So all this is going to actually take just a few minutes. So if you're interested, keep watching and I will demonstrate how it works. A little bit about myself. I'm Dimitri. I'm the developer of InfraNodus, this app that you see right now on your screen. I've been working on it for the last 10 years, and I like to share my insights and AI workflows on this channel. So if you find it interesting or if you want to support it, please subscribe so that other people get recommended these same videos. So let's dive right in. First, to begin, we need to go to the apps page and open the new apps in InfraNodus so we can select market analysis app. We click here, study market and search engine optimization, demand versus supply, because that's what we want to study. We want to identify what are the things in the market that people search for but don't yet find. And this is exactly what this app does. I will show you how it works in a few seconds. So I will start with this search query. I'm interested in real estate in Berlin, Germany, because it's a horrible market, doesn't work well. So I think there's a lot of opportunity there. And then I click on demand versus supply and I give this graph a name here. And what happens is that InfraNodus will import search results for this query from Google, visualize them as a graph to show you the main ideas inside. So this is the graph of the current informational supply. It's what people find when they search for real estate Berlin, Germany. Obviously, these search terms I erased from the graph because otherwise they would take all the attention. So we see that there's a lot of words like property sale, German, home, house here, and so on, right? So this is the graph of the current informational supply. Then we have another graph, which is the graph of the informational demand. So these are the search queries. You actually can see them on the left here that people use also when they search for real estate in Berlin, Germany. And you can see that, for instance, they use keywords like apartment, for rent, cheap, sale, house, and so on. And what this graph does is that it actually overlays these two graphs on top of each other, and it shows you what is in the current informational demand that is not in supply. So it's like, what are the combinations of words people use when they search for something where they don't really find so much search results? And you can actually see this here really well. You see that there's something on sale, cheap sale. So for example, that's the combinations that people use when they search for real estate in Berlin. Cheap sale, cheap apartments for sale, cheap houses for sale. But they don't really get search results for this as much. I would like to note here that, of course, when they search for real estate, they will find something on sales. But we're not just showing the words here, we're showing the combinations that they don't find. And this is much more interesting and relevant because you really get into the context of things in this case, right? So for example, cheap sale is one, cheap apartments is another one. If we click on the words, we see which words they're connected to. So that means they're used together in search by our potential clients. And then we also have something on student rent accommodation here and so on, right? So we have all those ideas laid out, and the bigger they are, the more relevance they have. So there's definitely something about cheap sale, house, apartment. And what we can do is to actually take all these insights, they're shown here. And then if we click on AI idea, InfraNodus will generate a business idea for us based on this graph. And here it says that create a platform focused on small affordable properties in Berlin, targeting international students and foreigners. It uses a Reddit-like system for community-driven insights on neighborhood like Kreuzberg, emphasizing properties that are cheap to buy or rent long-term and furnished directly from owners. So that could be our business idea. In fact, you can regenerate a few of them, and I will show you later in the video how you can make it a bit more precise. But for now, we will just copy this idea. And then we go into Bolt AI and we just create a new project from scratch. And we simply paste this idea directly from InfraNodus here, click run. And what happens here, what Bolt does is pretty amazing. It creates a whole new React app and then it creates the whole structure, makes the design, generates images, generates text from it. So you actually have a whole website ready for you in just like a minute or two. It installs everything you need. And then if you like it, you can reiterate a few more times by using the prompt here on the left. So you ask it to fix some things. I'll show you how you do that. And then you would click deploy and it's already available online and you can already send it to a few clients, see their reaction, see if it's something that works. So here we go. We have a ready-made website made for us and it's exactly following the brief that we gave it, that it's a platform focused on small affordable properties in Berlin, targeting international students and foreigners. So it's in English. It has those searchable listings. We can even see if that works. Doesn't yet, but we can fix it later. Then we can choose also the neighborhoods that we would like to filter and so on. So you already have some kind of listings here, some insights that are social insights from the users here, and already some possibilities to search or to add new stuff. So for instance, we can say, okay, now make the filters for price and neighborhoods work, and also make it possible to add a new post and make sure that the posts always reflect the areas in the listings. Okay, so we just kind of improve this a little bit, and what it's going to do is that it's going to make some changes, add some new functionalities, and usually with two or three prompts, my experience is that it becomes something that is more or less ready, and then you make a few changes yourself, either in the code or by using the chat prompt, and then you can deploy it and have it running online. So it's pretty cool because not only it allows you to build something, it's also a great way to actually create prototypes to see how it would look like, because you will never have this impression if you don't build it. But if you build it and you look at it, you will get a much better sense of whether this idea is good or not. So that I find is pretty interesting. Let's see what it built. So here it's rewriting the ideas. While it's happening, I'm going to show you how InfraNodus can be used to generate more ideas. So if we go back here and we open this graph again, I think we had it here, yeah. What you can do also is just to regenerate a few ideas from this button here and save some of them into notes. So for example, I ask it to generate some more ideas. If I see something I like, here it's talking about 3D tours, for example, of apartments. So I'm saving them into notes. I can even remove some stuff from the graph, like student, for example, if I'm not interested in making it for students only. And then it's going to recalculate everything based on the graph that you see. So it's kind of nice because makes it really possible for you to kind of like change the ideas that it generates and to kind of cater them directly to the stuff that you also find yourself interesting. And you have the graph to do that. So it's a very easy interface. You just select a word that you don't want to have inside and you hide it. And then everything is recalculated automatically. And you also can use these buttons here from the analytics panel. So for example, here, it also identifies a gap, right? So it's the clusters that could be better connected. It's another approach to identifying what's missing. And then you can generate some ideas here. By default, it generates a question, but you can ask it to generate a business idea. And then once it generated an idea, you can also save it into notes and add it to your list of ideas. And then once you finish doing that, you can just create a summary of all those notes. So it's just going to summarize everything. Then you click copy, and then in the same way, you can actually ask Bolt to build you a new website. So here we go. Here is a new version. Let's see how that works. You see, so the filters now work on the left. Then what else do we have? I think the filter also for the price works as well. Very good. And let's see, Neukölln. So here it's giving us some feedback on the areas, which is really great. And then now the post button also works. You see, so I can click post and I can post a new property very easily, and then it appears on this website. So if students or expats or foreigners or tourists come to this website, they can quickly see the apartments. They can use this tab here to understand what are the good areas, and then they can click on details. This doesn't work well, so we can make it work and also see all the discussions about it, right? So now the next extraction would be make it possible to view the details of the listing and also view the comments to it when you click the relevant buttons in the listings and so on. Right, so you do a few iterations, you have it made like this. You can even attach a login system later. It also can do that. You would probably need to fix some things in the code. So if you don't know how to code, you could also then go on Upwork or something like this and hire a freelancer to do that for you. So it's not something that's really hard to do. If you get stuck with the AI here at this point, you can also ask a freelancer or someone who knows how to code to fix all those specific things for you. And of course, also here, you see, instead of the database, it just uses some fixed variables with the data on apartments and on the comments. So if you need to attach a database, you can also ask it to do that actually. And you would maybe like make a database outside somewhere in on Supabase, or for example, you can use Aerolaw, which is like an advanced version of Google Sheets. So you add all the information there and it's gonna be stored in those virtual tables. And then you just load this information for your website from there. So all this is solvable and it's just going to take you really like maximum a few hours, but already in a few minutes you have a prototype that you can deploy. So this is kind of like what it builds. And while it's building that again, let me also, I think it's already ready. Okay, so we let it load. And as you can see here, now if we click on details, we have the information about the apartments. And if we click on comments, we also have comments. Let's see if the comments work already. Ah, they work. So you see, we just built a whole website in less than 12 minutes and I haven't even started. So it's a pretty amazing tool. I really recommend you to use it. And what's great is that we don't just come up with some idea out of blue. We actually used InfraNodus to identify the gap in the market. So what people search for, what they don't find, we identify the gap, we generate a few ideas, we summarize them into something that's relevant, and then we give this instruction to this powerful tool to build something for us. I actually did a few more versions, so it always changes depending on how your search query is phrased. So it had another idea for some community insights driven website here, as you can see. Another one was on finding matches between tenants and landlords. So I actually built a few ideas. And usually you would just want to choose a few of them and maybe go for the best one. So obviously, if you really want to build a real business from it, it probably makes sense to build a few prototypes, take a look at them, see how they feel, show it to a few friends, and then you can decide on which one would be working the best. And here, if I click deploy, it's going to go online and it's going to give me a link where it's going to be available. So that's pretty amazing, I find. We are still under 15 minutes. We already have a website that we can build. And it's actually a complicated one because it's a listing with social features, with directories. I mean, that's crazy. And like here, it provided me a link. Let's see. I'm going to be, yeah, so I have to log in. But basically, if I log in, I think I can make it public. Or maybe it's here. Yeah, so it's public. You see, I already have a link to this website. I'm actually going to leave it in the comments below so you can test that I'm not lying. It actually worked. And yeah, I find it's pretty amazing. So look, we have the logo, we have the text, we have the listings. Of course, we need to replace some stuff to make it work, but this is already a great thing to show to people and demonstrate to them how it works. So try it out for your own business ideas. Just to give you a little taster of what else is possible, let's just try something completely different. Let's go back into this app. Demand versus supply, and let's look for, I don't know, like health foods. Let's take something general like this. Something from another universe, from real estate to health foods. We identify the gap again. So here, important to say that you need to remove the word that you are searching for because otherwise it's going to take too much attention. So I remove it. So we see the graph here of the combinations of words that people search for, but for which they don't really find the results. So eat every day, eat healthy. Let's actually get rid of also healthy because it's kind of like a synonym. and eat. Maybe eat, we eat. No, let's get rid of it. Okay. Charts. So that's interesting. So people search a lot for charts, diet charts, but they don't find anything. Okay. Let's now go to recommended content ideas. Click on AI idea and see what idea is generated. Create a local harvest map app that connects users to nearby stores and markets selling organic, nutrient-dense foods. It includes interactive nutrition charts tailored for both adults and kids, printable worksheets for meal planning, and features daily discounts on vitamins and supplements. It promotes plant-based protein snacks and highlights the, let's see what else. A personalized grocery app that recommends organic food and supplement choices based on users' health data, integrating a diet chart feature to track vitamin intake and promote healthy eating habits. I like this one more because it's shorter. So let's copy this. Go to Bolt again, make a new app, paste this idea into Bolt, and watch a new prototype built in just a couple of minutes. I think that's a much easier one because it doesn't involve any listings. And I just wanted to show you that really it can work for anything you want. And that's what I find pretty amazing now, that you can build prototypes so easily. So marketing is going to become a huge issue here. Understanding the market is something that InfraNodus can really help you with. Also promoting it as well, because once you know what people are searching for but don't yet find, like we have here, we know that if we talk about charts and meal charts, then probably people will be searching for it. There's not enough information online yet on the subject. So it means that we would create a lot of articles on charts and a lot of pages on that website for various meal charts, printable charts that people can use to plan and to kind of design their diets and so on. So we already know how we're going to sort of infiltrate into the market, because we'll be targeting those combinations of words like we see here, charts, printable charts, that people use when they search for healthy food, but that they don't yet find. So that's really great for us, because it's also a hint of how to promote our stuff. So let's get to it. We have a whole website here. We have Eco Grocer here, recommended for you. So here it's giving me some advice. So it says, okay, you have a health profile here, you have your health goals, and it recommends you the stuff that you need to eat and shows you how well you would actually benefit from eating those foods, right? So that's really great. I mean, I like this because it's almost like a personal tracker app that also recommends you products. So there's some ideas on how you can collaborate also with delivery companies, for instance, or nearby shops to actually monetize it. So that's another example of building an app from scratch that addresses an underserved niche in the market. So that's really great. I like it. And you can try it for anything, as I said. So if you're interested to learn how it works, log on to InfraNodus to build those graphs for the different market gaps. Find something that you also personally like, because you need to be passionate about this, I think. It doesn't only have to be a good money-making opportunity. It needs to be something that you feel you're interested in a genuine way in. And then use Bolt to build those stuff. By the way, I'm not paid by Bolt or anything. I just find this app is really useful, so that's why I'm recommending it. Thank you. And if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments to the video. I'll be happy to answer.